Hey guys, it's Josh, the 98 Know-It-All, coming to you today with my third installment of my baseball memories, things that I have cherished, and big reasons why I love the game of baseball. The first one dealt with me meeting Ken Griffey Jr. No explanation needed for that one. Second one was my daughter's first ever baseball game that I took her to, the no-hitter by the Mariners against the Dodgers. No explanation needed there as well. This one is a little bit different, but it's still something that is pretty important to me. It's actually two moments, but I'm going to put them together for a reason. But guys, before we do that, please like, comment, or subscribe to the channel. It does help out when you guys do that stuff. The YouTube algorithm, the more that people interact with me, it actually helps put it out there so more people can see it. So please take a moment to do that. It just helps me out, help more people see it, and just be a part of our conversations and baseball life. So guys, today I'm talking about another memory that I have. This is number three once again, and it's actually two moments put together. It's two firsts that I got to see. When I was down in Salem, I lived in Salem, Oregon for a couple years, actually almost 10 years. I got to do a lot of things with the minor league team there, the Salem Kaiser Volcanoes, and I got to see a lot of things. I got to see a lot of brand new players to professional baseball. I was there for Joe Panik's first game ever. I got to be there for really a lot of players who were drafted out of college and sent to the league, and I got to see them play for the first time. So a lot of fun. A lot of great players have come through there, and two of the players that I got to witness and see, you know, had some key moments for me. The first one I got to see was Mike Zunino. It wasn't his first game that I got to see him in, but I actually got to photograph him batting and hitting his first home run. I was actually there for his first home run as professional. It was with the Aqua Sox out of Everett. I actually have that photo. And then when I went to a Mariner Fan Fest, I think like 2 years later, I got him to sign it. So Mike Zunino, his first ever professional home run. I was there for that. Got to photograph it. This is the swing, and he actually drilled that ball. Just drilled it. Flat out drilled it. The second memory I have that's kind of connected with this is another first. Chris Stratton. He was the first round pick for the Giants in 2012, I think. Don't quote me on that. It's somewhere around that time frame. But I was doing kind of the photographs for the Volcanoes at the time. They didn't really have any other photographers. And so I get to the game. I was usually there about an hour ahead of time. And one of the guys in the front office was like, "Hey, Josh, go down and get photos to start the game. We need him pitching." And so I got to go down right up against the, you know, right behind the net. And I got to be the photographer to take photos of Chris Stratton and his first professional pitch in his career. And those photos were actually used by the Giants. It was used by minor league baseball. I think major league baseball used them, talking about their first round picks, that type of stuff. So it actually got used quite a bit. And so I printed that off and actually had him sign that one as well. So that was pretty cool for me, because not only was I the photographer to get his first professional pitch ever, but my photo got used a number of places. In fact, that photo actually is what sparked 98 Know-It-All to be really what it is today. Because at that point, I was only getting about 5 views a day, maybe 5 views a day. I'd go days where I'd get 0 or 1, and I wasn't real consistent with doing stuff for the site. When I took this photo and put it out, I tweeted it to the Giants, who retweeted it out. And that day, I think I had like 2,000 people come to my site and view that picture in like 60-minute time span. It was more views in 1 hour than I had in probably a year combined. So it changed. I was like, whoa, this is something. This is big. This is, you know, I could do this. And that's when I really started focusing on photos a lot more. So there were some stretches with the site 98 Know-It-All where there's not a lot of blog posts, But if you were to look back at the stats, you would see there's still a lot of views because I was doing photos of local colleges, the minor league teams, just wherever I could get my hands on, wherever I'd go to and take photos. So really became kind of the cornerstone of 98 Know It All was the photos, and it really be started because of this photo right here. It changed the path of the site. It was cool to share it with him. I actually gave him some copies of the photo, and then he signed obviously some for me as well. And it's just, it's one of those moments that it was special for me to be a part of that, and then to share it with the player himself. So I have other ones. I actually got some photos of guys hitting their first home runs as well, like Mike Zunino, and I was able to share photos with them. One guy actually was able to find the ball because where he hit it, no one could go there except for staff. And since I was the team's photographer and working with kind of the grounds crew, we went back there and I found it, got the ball, brought it back, and he handed him the ball and a picture the next day. So lots of fun memories like that. I love doing things like that. It's why I'm doing what I'm doing. Even though I know I don't make any money and tend to lose more money than I make. In fact, I do lose a lot of money doing this, but it's fun. I do a lot of things for the players, for the families, for the teams, to help grow the game of baseball, and that's what I do. I'm okay with that. Maybe if you guys think that this is important, something to keep going, you'd be a supporter on Patreon. I have the link down below. It does help to have guys, have individuals support me, just so I can keep doing this, because it does take a toll financially and time-wise. But you know what? I still love doing it. Still have fun, and so that's my third baseball memory I wanted to share with you guys. Once again, if you have memories, leave a comment down below about your memories, or send me an email and connect with me. And if you write an article about your memories or what baseball means to you, we'll share it on the blog. We have guest writers all the time who do that. It's a lot of fun to read their stories. And yeah. So guys, I'm Josh, the 90 Know It All. Thanks for taking a few minutes to watch my video, and have a great day.